loss in three preseason tests, all of them on the road. The Canucks return home with their strongest lineup yet, hoping to break through against the Oilers in the second meeting between these two teams in the last 4 days. Jack Campbell was excellent in an overtime win in Calgary last night. 24 hours later, it's Stuart Skinner in goal for the visitors. Skinner stopped 21 shots in a 2-1 overtime win against the Canucks on Wednesday. For the home team, it's Thatcher Demko for a second straight game. Demko, one of the bright spots in Thursday's 3-1 defeat in Seattle. He missed 35 games last year due to injury, but went 11-4-2 after returning to the Vancouver lineup. Carson Soucy won't have Connor McDavid to contend with tonight, but he did a pretty good job against the Oilers superstar Wednesday in Edmonton. And ex-Canuck Brandon Sutter is set to play his first game at Rogers Arena since April 24, 2021. Sutter having a pretty good showing this preseason in his comeback bid with the Oilers. And there's some thought, Dave, that he might just fit the bill for something the Oilers could use here heading into the regular season.
A right shot centerman who can kill faceoffs, kill penalties, and he's a popular figure within the Oilers dressing room as well.
Jay Woodcroft will ultimately make that decision whether Brandon Sutter makes the team, but he's on the ice to start this game for the Oilers, who are 2-1-1 in the preseason thus far. Dropped their first two, but have back-to-back overtime wins against the Canucks and last night in Calgary. And after the pregame ceremony, we are set to go. Teddy Bluger between Nils Omark and Jack Studnicka to start for the Canucks. Carson Soucy, Tyler Myers on defense. Sutter, Adam Ernie, and Matthias Janmark up front for the Oilers, and we're underway with Soucy controlling in his own blue line and setting the puck ahead. Picked up by Studnicka, who feeds back into his own zone. Tyler Myers fires the puck forward. Oilers send it the other way. And now it's over the Vancouver blue line, picked up by Janmark, who gets around Soucy, but over to knock the puck away was Teddy Bluger on a nice defensive play. Myers starts up, banks one ahead. Bluger was knocked down by Vincent Desharnais. And the puck back over the Vancouver blue line. Soucy looks up ice with a pass to Studnicka, who starts the first change of the game for both teams.
One of the things about a left shot defenseman playing on the right side is their stick, when they open up to pivot, has the longer reach, and Soucy was able to use that to his advantage on that shift.
Oilers called for icing, and the faceoff will come back into the Edmonton zone.
Teddy Bluger, the defensive conscious on this line, and he's going to help out with this back check as Soucy almost grabbed the puck completely and then looking to break out after that. Good in the faceoff circle, and going to be one of the improvements on the penalty kill for the Canucks this season.
He was noticeable in that role in Edmonton on Wednesday. Here's Hughes, a long shot into the crest of the jersey in the first test of the game for Skinner. He hangs on.
And it's a good idea that Quinn Hughes is looking to shoot the puck, but it's going to be a lot of Oilers early. There's the bench boss for Edmonton. I mean, they've got their sights set higher than the second round. It'll be a lot of Edmonton to start the season.
Coming off a 50-win season, the Oilers. And yes, these two teams will open the season with a home-and-home here in Vancouver on Wednesday, October 11th, and in Edmonton on Saturday, October 14th. Here's Phil DiGiuseppe playing with JT Miller and Brock Besser. Miller sweeps the puck to the right point. Cole McWard finds Hughes, who makes a move through a couple of Oilers, gets in on the backhand, but he hoisted that over top of the goal. Besser dumps one to the corner. DiGiuseppe kicks the puck to his stick, puts it behind the net towards Miller. Got past him, and he's checked by Evan Bouchard, who now brings the puck forward for the Oilers, but turns it over. Besser chips it far side. Hughes has some room. Cutting towards the goal, puts one in front. It went right through the crease. No Canuck could get a stick on it. Puck thrown towards the goal by Ian Cole. Here's DiGiuseppe behind the net for Miller. Centers Besser, shot it wide. And that line will start to change as the Oilers clear the puck down to the Vancouver blue line.
Some offensive flair on that line, and that's the right guy to get the puck at the right spot, Brock Besser.
Ian Cole dumps the puck in from center. Number 82 for the Canucks, paired on defense with Philip Perona. Andre Kuzmenko working from behind the goal. Back to Cole. His shot off the stick of Stuart Skinner. Canucks get the puck back. Kuzmenko hit along the boards. He was checked there by Brad Malone, who had the overtime winner in Calgary last night. Malone skates to the Vancouver blue line. Canucks break that up. Now the puck through to Demko, and he'll settle it down for Cole. 2.5 in, no score. Canucks have had the better of the zone time thus far and have the first two shots of the game. Oilers intercept the puck at center, but now it's picked up and handled by Puse Suter. Perona delays before trying to throw on forward. It deflects towards Connor Garland, but it's a hand pass, and that stops play just outside the Oilers blue line.
Well, with DiGiuseppe, it's important for him to create loose pucks, make some plays, gets a little yell from Miller, who knows that Besser's going to be in the slot. Trying to go glove side, just hits a stick. You'd like to see Brock Besser in those scoring areas, a little bit lighter here at the start of the season. In the preseason, looking to light the lamp and get himself going for this regular season coming up.
Hoping to start this regular season healthy. And that's been an issue, not of his, not to fault him, but had some bad luck starting years in recent times. Demko out of his net, sends the puck around. Niels Omon tried to poke it, couldn't reach. And Philip Broberg sends Seth Griffith over the Vancouver blue line. Griffith dishes off Raphael Lavoie after the puck behind the Vancouver goal. Now Brandon Sutter's onto it, back to the blue line. Broberg, right point. Desharnais fakes the shot, feeds one down towards Janmark. That was broken up by McWhorter, who's up there right now with Carson Soucy. Canucks mid change, I think. Although it was Horonic and Cole out there last, so this may be by design. Here's an attempted shot by Ernie that went wide of the goal. Battle for the puck in the corner to the right of Demko. Jammed up the board, Stanika couldn't reach it, and it stays deep in the Vancouver zone. Ernie to Sutter, back to the left point, Grover. Down to Brandon Sutter, lost it in his skates for a moment. Now Janmark centering pass, picked off by Soucy, and he'll turn and dump the puck off the glove of Bouchard and out to center ice.
Talkie did say that they might switch some D partners for Quinn Hughes throughout games, and Sick had done that early in this one.
Hughes has come on now, so he's paired with McWhorter at the moment, as that long shot is blocked away by Demko, the first shot of the game for the Oilers. Evander Kane helps the puck around to the near side. McWhorter after it there. Held in at the right point by Connor Brown, who sends one across. Darnell Nurse. Good zone time for the Oilers here. Bouchard, long shot, deflected, just went wide. Demko never saw it. It was Nugent Hopkins, I think. Now there's a Vancouver penalty coming up. After this pressure by the Oilers, Bouchard dishes off. Here's a shot by Nurse, stopped by Demko. Another centering pass, and that was put wide by Nugent Hopkins. Some great chances for the Oilers, who will now go to the power play for the first time in this scoreless game.
Well, you get running around in late in a shift, and usually a penalty ensues near the front of the net. This one was deflected wide on the glove side, and there's your cross check. So McWhorter will sit, a bit of an extended shift for him, and the Oilers power play without its key figures in Draisaitl and McDavid will take the ice.
By extended, the official time of his shift was 2 minutes. And so McWhorter now gets a breather in the penalty box, hoping he'll be there for the full 2 minutes. Bouchard to Nugent Hopkins. Pass was deflected, but puck came right in front. Demko, two saves off Kane. Back-to-back stops for Thatcher Demko after that puck pinballed its way in front. Now Bouchard with a shot. Demko might have taken that off the mask. Here's Bouchard at the right point. Kane to Nugent Hopkins. Connor Brown. Nugent Hopkins across for Lane Peterson. Tees it up for Bouchard. Broke his stick. Canucks will try to take advantage. Miller, and sliding over was Bouchard to make a good defensive play. But they're going to call it a hand pass, which is certainly worth not giving up a breakaway, as JT Miller was trying to spring a teammate.
Demko ready to read the puck coming in front. And Kane puts it right into the logo. Good positioning. Taking it from backhand to forehand, as they're trying to protect that area right near the front of the net. But Thatcher Demko is able to stay big enough for long enough.
Oilers with the last five shots in the game now, including those two quick ones off the stick of Kane. Power play unit remains the same for the Oilers. Again, no McDavid, no Drysdale in this game. Bouchard. And now Nugent Hopkins starts up through center. Dumps the puck in and chases after it himself. Tyler Myers on him, and Nugent Hopkins comes up with the puck. Sets up shop on the left wing, dishes down low. Brown back up to Nugent Hopkins. Here's Connor Brown looking across. Back to Bouchard, settles the puck, lets it go. That one off the stick of Jack Stonikin, wide of the goal. Oilers still control. Bouchard. Nugent Hopkins shoots, blocks, gets it again. And that one was off a leg and wide of the goal. 35 seconds to go in the power play. Nugent Hopkins down to Kane, puts it in front. Brown couldn't steer it on goal, but he gets the puck once more. Great control for the Oilers, looking to open the scoring in this one. Nugent Hopkins to the goal line. Kane across, pass was behind Lane Peterson. Here's Bouchard. Peterson shoots, Demko the save, Kane on the rebound, stop. Loose puck cleared to the side by Suter. Demko looks sharp early, as he's had to make some key stops on this man advantage, which is into its dying seconds. Bouchard, Nugent Hopkins shoots, blocker saved by Demko. McWard's out of the box, and the Canucks are back to full strength in what remains a scoreless game, thanks to the goaltending of Thatcher Demko.
And he was excellent last game as well against the Seattle Kraken. And that's an extended shift that drew the penalty, an extended power play for the Oilers. And thank Thatcher Demko for the fact that it's still scoreless.
Here are the Canucks at the other end. Kuzmenko drag move, tried a wrist shot. That went off the skate of Broberg. Loose puck behind the goal. Kuzmenko gets it to Elias Pettersson, back to Quinn Hughes. Right point, Hronek. That was tipped wide by Kuzmenko. Now Bavilia into the corner for Kuzmenko. Up to Hughes. Quinn Hughes, nice pass. Pettersson wanted to shoot, but he was poke checked by Broberg. Lavoie gets the puck, tips it out. Held in by Kuzmenko, good job of the line. Here's Pettersson buying some time. Dishes near side to Bavilia. Drop for Hughes, behind for Kuzmenko. Centering pass off the mark, trying to find Hronek, and the puck slides all the way down into the Vancouver zone.
Now, one of the issues with taking a penalty early in the game is that if you're not a penalty killer, you're stuck watching. So Pettersson's first shift is in zone, though, offensively.
Just about 8.5 minutes into the first period. The clock on the big spanking new scoreboard has stopped. It's at 15:36, but we can tell you off our on-screen clock that we're 8:40 now into the first period. Oilers intercept a pass in front of their own goal, and the puck is backhanded down the ice by Niemelainen. No icing as McWard goes back for the puck. Leaves for Cole, gave it away, and a nice save by Demko off Lane Peterson. Demko at the ready as the puck was turned over up the middle. And after some good work against the Oilers' power play, Thatcher Demko had to make another stop right here to keep this game scoreless.
Hello, my name is Chief Willie Sellers with the Williams Lake First Nation.
No, that was this morning here, Rogers Arena. Willie Sellers, the elected chief of Williams Lake First Nation, speaking to the Canucks about the importance of the National Day for Truth and Reconciliation. And if you want to hear what he had to say, just go to Canucks.com for the full speech.
Pre-game ceremony, very well executed. And a lot of orange scattered around the building tonight. Scoreless game. Canucks and the Oilers were 9 minutes into the first period. Canucks had the first two shots of the game. Oilers have had the last seven, and it felt like they actually didn't tally enough after the Oilers got to five, and Demko made a couple other saves, it felt like, but official tally there is Rick Tocchet hopes to see some action at the Oilers' end of the ice.
Yeah, and he's been talking to his forwards, specifically the wingers, and have been talking about them getting the puck out of the zone. But when you get the puck in your stick, you have two plays. You move your feet or you make a crisp pass. And a lot of times the wingers hold on just a little bit too long. They get stuffed at the blue line, and then you get that extended shift in your own end.
Here's Hronek ahead. Garland tried to tip the puck in, but it ricocheted right into the Oilers bench, and they'll face off outside the Edmonton blue line. Oh, we're gonna get a souvenir.
Well, we'll see if this Canuck team can change his fortunes early here. Again, with the clock in front of us not functioning properly, you get kind of sidetracked thinking there's only a 4 minutes gone in the game, and we're halfway through the first.
Evan Bouchard to Brad Malone, who banks the puck ahead. His uncle's Greg Malone, who played over 700 games in the National Hockey League. From New Brunswick, Ian Cole tracks back for a loose puck. Got hooked in the corner by Seth Griffin. Pew Suter, bodied by Lane Peterson. Puck squirts free to Jack Studnicka, who put Hronek in a bit of a pickle. He banks the puck the other way, straight through to Skinner, and whoa, he'll take the whistle, but Oman might hear about that as he took Nima Leinen right into his own goaltender. And the Oilers converge on Nils Oman.
Well, one of the things the Canucks are trying to do from defensemen to forwards, indirect passes where the forwards will just continue to skate right up ice. And Oman was trying to hold up from getting into the goaltender. And Nima Leinen was one that took the worst of it. Feet got tangled up. Oman, mostly a centerman last year, but they've moved him to the wing. His faceoffs weren't where you'd like them to be, but he has the size and the range, and now he's...
I think he falls into that category that Rick Tocchet's been talking about. Here's Kuzmenko off the draw. Dishes off. Myers with a shot. That didn't get through. Pettersson gets the loose puck. And his pass intercepted. But I think Oman falls into that group of he's trying to find big bodies that can skate and will get in and create turnovers. And doesn't necessarily have to be big. He wants to see that from Nils Höglander. He obviously wants to see it from Pod Coles and Dakota Joshua, Nils Oman as well, and I think that's part of the reason he's on the wing. Not to mention the fact that they are deeper at center ice this year.
Yeah, you got DiGiuseppe, who's up the lineup.
Yep.
It's his job. Archie Baines, like to see him get a look sometime this season if it goes to injuries and you want that big body in the lineup.
Here's Quinn Hughes. Threw it right through to the goaltender. He was trying to hit DiGiuseppe, the blue line. Good hustle from Miller to get to the loose puck. Besser hit the side of the net with that shot. Similar to his first scoring chance, both of them missed on that side. Here's Miller in front. DiGiuseppe couldn't steer it on goal. Hughes hustles down from the blue line, but he was checked, and Nugent Hopkins fires the puck out for Evander Kane, who tips it over the Vancouver blue line. Just over 8.5 minutes remaining in the opening period. Besser heads to the bench after tipping the puck to the corner. Oilers. Sutter starts out. Passes one across neutral ice. Kane gets the puck, and he'll hoist it over the Vancouver blue line. Ian Cole able to play it away from Matthias Janmark. And the puck slides down far enough for an icing call against the Canucks. Blue Jays wrap up their series with the Rays tomorrow. They failed to clinch at their end, but if Seattle loses tonight, it'll get taken care of. The game tomorrow, 11:30 Pacific, 2:30 Eastern, right here on Sportsnet. Of course, we're in Vancouver, so mixed emotions. We can cheer for the Mariners too, right?
Well, I'm sure you can. Some people follow them as well.
Here's a shot by Nurse. He hammered that wide of the goal. Bouchard hit the side of the net with that one. Nils Höglander pass for Connor Garland. Threw one ahead just out of the reach of Pew Suter. Höglander, good job to block the clearing attempt of Stuart Skinner. Now he battles Nurse for the puck behind the goal. Garland there in support. Oilers send the puck up the board. Suter intercepts. Here's Höglander behind the goal. Nils Höglander making moves, looking in front, center of the puck, and that ticked off Nurse. A pass intended for Connor Garland. Griffith takes the puck into the Vancouver zone. Garland in his own zone. End of his shift, he'll get to center, dump the puck in and head to the bench.
Tocchet's gonna like that shift. Puck support in the offensive zone. Smart plays, get it behind the net and then try to work it to a scoring area up front. The pass just didn't connect.
I think you'll like Höglander winning a puck battle with Darnell Nurse as well.
Yeah, that's what started it all.
Here's Susie passing in front of his own goal to Tyler Myers. Indirect feed, and Bluger tips the puck into the Edmonton zone. Holman leaves in the corner for Stanika. Makes a move behind the net. Banks one back to Quinn Hughes. Ball with the puck, just held it onside, but his pass was picked up. Stanika throws a hit on James Hamblin and now gets the puck and whips it back into the Oilers' end.
One of the big things that Rick Tocchet talked about in the game in Seattle and through the preseason games is players winning puck battles. He's really big on what do you do when the puck's up against the boards and you're battling with someone. You better come up with it.
Hughes gloved that puck to Kuzmenko, but inside their own zone, so play continues. McWard to Elias Pettersson, and he'll turn back. Hughes takes his pass, left wing at center, sends the puck into the Oilers' end. Beauvillier leaves in the corner for Kuzmenko. Behind the net for Beauvillier, couldn't handle the pass. Broberg gets the puck and backhands it ahead, picked off at center by Hughes. Kuzmenko's in. Here's Pettersson with room, and he couldn't take the pass cleanly. Could have been a bit of a two-on-one down low with Beauvillier. Now Pettersson heading to the bench, wasn't expecting the pass. And the puck is back down behind the Vancouver goal. JT Miller gave that one away. Nugent Hopkins in transition. Into the Vancouver zone with a wrist shot attempt that was blocked. Besser chips the puck ahead. Intercepted by Nurse, who's immediately checked by Miller. He slides the puck to an open wing. Bouchard dumps the puck into the Vancouver. Cole to the blue line, not out. Corona intercepts in the corner, trying to get it ahead to Besser. Oilers pick that off. Here's Bouchard right point, but the puck escaped the zone. DiGiuseppe steals it, backhands it wide to the Edmonton goal. Suter's come onto the ice, making moves in the corner. Pugh Suter back to Susie. Richard wide of the goal, trying to go high glove side. Nurse has lost his stick. Kane intercepts, and he gets to center and tips the puck over the Vancouver blue line.
Much better this game. The Canucks are coming up with pucks once they're dumped in, and then it's not just looking near the front of the net. And look to that second level back to the blue line.
Here's a shoot in on Demko. Blocker to the side. Susie gets the loose puck, and he leaves for Tyler Myers.
You can hear him call for that up here.
There's a nice tip pass. Bluger to Stanika. Excellent defensive play by the other number 23, Seth Griffin. As it looked like Stanika might have a step on the right wing. Here's Hughes getting away from his man. Quinn Hughes shoots high and wide on the short side. And then McWard couldn't keep the puck into the right point. Cole McWard starting out of his own zone. Pass to Teddy Bluger. He gets to the Oilers blue line. Loses the puck there. And back comes Lavoie. Raphael Lavoie trying to go through the defense and couldn't get through. 4 minutes to go. No score. First period. Lane Peterson dumped by Oman at center. Oilers trying to break in. There's a penalty coming up as that backhander by Hamblin was stopped. And now the whistle sounds for a slashing call. And the Canucks will be shorthanded for a second time as Andre Kuzmenko heads to the box.
Just over a week and a half before the Canucks get going for real. They'll do it against this Oilers team, albeit with 97 lineup. October 11th, you can get your tickets. Canucks.com/tickets.
Back to the penalty kill for the Canucks. Kuzmenko, as Hamblin gets this turnover, and he had a head of steam to slice through players, but couldn't handle the puck because of that slash. So some more penalty killing work for Vancouver. It looks like they're more disciplined and more patient with their penalty kill.
I don't know if it's their number one priority, but one of their top priorities is to eliminate the seam passes that plagued them all year last season. Makes life for the goaltender a lot easier if he knows he's not going to have to go post to post for a one-timer.
Yeah, there's two things. If you're the forward group, you've got to be a little bit lower so you protect the seam, but that just leaves the points wide open. And if you have a team that likes the one-timer, Evan Bouchard has a pretty heavy shot.
Might call it a bomb. Here's Brown under pressure. Bluger steals the puck, and he sends it all the way down the ice. 40 seconds gone in the penalty to Andre Kuzmenko. 3 minutes remaining. First period, no score. Pettersson is aggressive at the offensive blue line. Now he hustles back to break things up at his own blue line, and he and Miller are going to break out. Led the league in shorthanded points last year. They tied with 9, but they couldn't break in on that one. Miller this time just chops the puck deep into the Oilers zone and starts a Vancouver change.
You love the direction the league is going over the last 5-6 years. Killing a penalty instead of just firing it down the ice and changing up. Look for an offensive chance. Take the puck to the net, might draw a penalty, and Pettersson and Miller out in the ice. They certainly look to do that.
They each had 5 shorthanded goals last year. Each had 9 shorthanded points. And the Canucks, with 15 shorthanded goals, were second only to these Edmonton Oilers, who had 18 shorthanded goals. That puck sent off the glass and down into the Oilers' end with 25 seconds to go on the penalty to Kuzmenko.
And we see on the PK, it's Soucy and Hughes who team up. They're to the bench now.
Cole out with Myers for the remaining seconds of this Oiler power play. Myers intercepts, checked as he tried to send the puck ahead. Borgo gets it to Lavoie. His shot stopped, puck is cleared, and that'll do it. Oilers 0-for-2 on the power play, managed one shot on that one, and this game remains scoreless.
Well, one man down, but they outnumbered the Oilers when they had the puck in the zone, at least had help getting it down the ice.
Here's a long indirect pass, Janmark's in, put it on the forehand, got a shot away, and then Sutter can put on the rebound, but Ernie does. Adam Ernie spun and shot all in one motion. And the Oilers open the scoring with a minute 26 to go in the first.
Looked like the offensive chance was taken care of. Janmark's trying to get it to his forehand, does so with the rebound. Sutter with the flyby, but Ernie's able to find it, spin, and get it past the right pad before Demko can reach and kick out that right leg. So a couple of successful penalty kills, but it's 5-on-5 late in the first to put the Canucks down.
Looked for a moment like Beauvillier might have saved the goal as he came back and took the stick of Sutter, but Ernie was right there as the puck now goes out of play at the Oiler bench, and a faceoff upcoming in the neutral zone.
Pass up the ice from Nurse. Creates things and capitalized on.
Ernie spinning goal. Oilers have drawn first blood.
You can be here to experience every moment. Full half and quarter season ticket memberships on sale now, starting from 5 payments of $162.
Regular season again starts a week Wednesday. Canucks, 2 more preseason games after this one. They'll play Wednesday in Abbotsford against the Seattle Kraken. Close out next Friday at Rogers Arena against the Calgary Flames. In the final minute, first period, Oilers leading 1-0. And they go offside of the Vancouver blue line. Shots 14-4 in favor of the Oilers here in the first.
A couple of power plays helped that along. And you mentioned how they're playing Edmonton home and home to start the season. Then they'll play them again in November, and then not again until April.
But they do get them 4 times this year. Last year they only played Edmonton 3 times. I think Vegas was the other team in the division that they only played 3 times. You know how I know that? Because we only got 1 trip to Vegas. You take note of these things.
You're comparing Edmonton trips to Vegas trips?
I wouldn't have noticed that they only played Edmonton 3 times.
Right.
For the same reasons. But that was a good year to miss both those teams as they finished 1-2 in the Pacific Division. 111 and 109 points respectively.
I'm wondering if those two teams swap positionings for this season. Vegas thinking they know what it takes once the playoffs start, and Edmonton wanting to flex their muscles in the Pacific.
Here's Connor Brown sending the puck around. Broberg checked by Oma. 5 seconds left in the period as Bluger skates ahead with a long shot, gloved by Skinner, and that'll do it for period number 1. Adam Ernie, the only goal of the game thus far. came late in the first, and the visitors have the lead after 20 minutes. Martin Guyard, Faisal Kamiza coming up with a Sportsnet Central update for us. Murph will assemble the panel with Ian McIntyre and Satyar Shah. We're through one in the season for the Canucks. They trail the Oilers 1-0 as we go to the second period at Rogers Arena. Not a lot going on offensively for the Canucks in that opening period. They were outshot 14-5. But when there was something happening offensively, Dollars to Donuts, Quinn Hughes was involved and probably the catalyst behind it happening.
Just a treat to watch. And, you know, he's going to look to up his shot totals. I'd like to see him get 200-plus shots this season. Hasn't reached that lofty number just yet. But look at this, exploding the space and creating a scoring chance for himself. And just taking down, if Giuseppe has a stick on the ice, it's a tap-in. Hart passes to lead the offense, and watch this elusiveness. Watch his left leg, boom, right there. There's the crossover step that is so hard to defend if you're a forward. I think he's gotten quicker. I think he's gotten more elusive. And I'm looking forward to seeing what he brings this season.
Yeah, when you said that to me in the intermission, you said, I think he might be quicker. I was like, wow.
Yeah,
he's already pretty good.
He's silky, though, in the way that he uses his footwork and gets away and creates his own time and space. And game's easier when you have more time. Trust me.
I finally figured out what's different.
Good.
There was something that was just gnawing at me.
Okay.
It's the top of the boards.
Oh, I thought you meant your color guy.
No, well, that. Oh, right. They're blue now. Used to be red.
Yeah.
That's my observation for tonight. 1-0 Oilers lead underway second period. They have a chance for a 2-on-1 from the blue line in. Here's Janmark to the net, centering pass, and a nice job by Tyler Myers to break it up. As Janmark was trying to get the puck over to Brandon Sutter. Back come the Canucks. DiGiuseppe towards Bluger. And there to take the puck away is Evan Bouchard. Bouchard now lugs the puck ahead. Pass out of the reach of Nurse. And Hughes takes possession of the puck, sidesteps one man. Pass picked off by Nugent Hopkins, who's checked from behind by Brock Besser and loses the puck. Hughes ahead to DiGiuseppe, who deflects the puck over the glass, trying to get it deep into the Oilers' zone.
This puck in the neutral zone goes the Oilers' way. And that man right there was in the middle of things. Long reach, doesn't commit too soon, doesn't go down too soon, and is able to interrupt that pass across.
Fifteenth NHL season for the one-time Calder Trophy winner with the Buffalo Sabres. Here's a lead pass, a good one. Lavoie, checked by McWard, who's going to get his second penalty of the game. As McWard pulled down Raphael Lavoie, they'll call it a hold. And McWard skates to the penalty box. Oilers get their third power play.
Well, tough to contend with the size of Lavoie. So McWard will hope the PK comes to the forefront like it did in the first period to reach. But it brings Lavoie off balance enough that he doesn't get a full shot off. You want to get in there with the hands and then get them away quick enough. But Edmonton, third power play of the game.
All three power plays, Sam. Gone to the Oilers. Canucks have not had one. Edmonton went 0-for-4 against Vancouver in their meeting on Wednesday. Nugent Hopkins wins the faceoff back to Bouchard. And now Kane centers the puck. Peterson back to Bouchard. Lane Peterson takes the return pass. Here's Connor Brown to Ryan Nugent Hopkins. Brown again from the corner, all the way across. Cole, good job to get a stick on that pass intended for Peterson, who now has the puck. Leaves in the corner for Brown. Pass Nugent Hopkins. Goes around the net, puts it in front. Quick shot, blocked. Miller got in front of that one, I think, as Evander Kane tried to test Thatcher Demko. Here's Kane again, takes a whack from Philip Hronek. Bouchard down to Nugent Hopkins. Watched by Hronek. Brown has the puck on the goal line. Nugent Hopkins put it to the net, stopped by Demko, and the loose puck cleared down the ice by Vancouver. Long change for the Canucks. They're able to switch the forwards, but Cole and Hronek stay on the ice. Nugent Hopkins couldn't reach that one, and now the defense pair, at least Cole will head to the bench, and now Horonic follows suit.
It's okay to go down on the ice of the defenseman and slide to block that pass, as long as your winger can come down to help out, and that snuffed out a real good scoring passing opportunity right near the front of the net for the Oilers.
Good pressure at the blue line from Bluger and Myers. Oilers forced back. Here's Brown now. Pass Nugent Hopkins, who tips the puck to the corner, gets to it himself, but his pass is intercepted by Bluger, who read that well. He sends Niels Omont away. Omont tried to sidestep Boucher, and the Oilers take the puck back with Peterson starting up. Just over 20 seconds to go in the power play. Kane trying to go through the defense, and with poke check. And back comes Phil DiGiuseppe, one-on-one on Nurse. DiGiuseppe, wrist shot, glove saved by Skinner. And DiGiuseppe forces him to smother the puck with just a dozen seconds to go in the penalty to Cole McWard.
Smart play by DiGiuseppe to stay at the net. Omine had the same chance but decided not to shoot when he went up ice. And here's the slide I was talking about. There's the help from the forward coming down. So the reading off of each other, JT Miller knows to scramble back to the front of the net. Good PK so far.
Darnell Nurse, pass to Brandon Sutter. Banks the puck in. Hughes goes back for it. McWard's out of the box. Oilers had one shot on that power play. And they're now 0 for 3, 0 for 7 in two games against the Canucks. The 0 for 4 was maybe a little more telling because the Oilers had their full power play unit in that game. No McDavid, no Drysdale for this one tonight. There's a lead pass off the mark. That'll be no icing as Broberg goes back. Can't get it past Pugh Suter, who battles for the puck deep in the Oilers zone. Now Hoglander steals it, finds Suter. Back to Cole, he shoots, knocked down by Skinner. And the loose puck cleared out by Adam Ernie, who has the only goal in this game. Hoglander deflects the puck back in and heads to the Vancouver bench. Here's Nurse. Ahead to Borgo. Xavier Borgo checks, and back to pick up the puck is Miller. Pass across over the stick of Cole. Malone trying to jam it up the boards. That was blocked.
There's only four defensemen on the ice. There are four players.
Have we solved it?
What's that?
The number of players on the ice.
It's now solved. There's the fifth. McWard was the only defenseman.
There's a shot from the line. Demko trying to find it, and then it was swept wide by Xavier Borgo. From the line, Ben Gleason with a shot. Knocked down by Demko. Loose puck in front. He couldn't find it. But a good job by Miller to box out, and DiGiuseppe came back to get the puck. He ices it. But that looked for a moment like it could have been a tap-in for the Oilers.
Good stick by Miller at the front of the net. As Demko makes the initial stop and then can't find the rebound, it's sitting right in the blue paint. And DiGiuseppe was able to help out. Hoglander is going to pop into your screen. He moves back out and intercepts the pass. If he goes in any further, he doesn't get that puck. So real nice read by him to pop out and take that passing lane away and get a shot after it.
After the icing and the faceoff, Canucks able to work the puck down the ice. Oilers now try to move back through center. McWard stepped up on Evander Kane. Hughes across to Kuzmenko, who tries a pass for Pettersson, who will only reach out and tip the puck to the corner. Played away from him, and the puck is back down inside the Vancouver blue line. Hughes to Pettersson. Trying to go back to Hughes. Oilers got a piece of that. Cole McWard. Kuzmenko tipped the puck in past Niemelainen. Bovillier first man in after him. Pettersson from behind. That tried to wrap around. Bovillier kept the puck alive as Skinner was trying to cover it. But the Oilers able to move it out to center, and Gleason dumps the puck over the Vancouver blue line.
And that top line is able to create some chances. Kuzmenko played less than 4 minutes in that first period.
Here's Pettersson to Kuzmenko. Roenick racing to join him. Kuzmenko passes one across. Cole hustles to the puck. Ian Cole dumps it around. Pugh Suter's there. Lets it go to Connor Garland with some room. Garland with a shot. That sailed wide. Cole gets the puck on the near side. Takes a hit. Thrown to the far corner by Suter. LeBois for the Oilers. Lead pass. Garland broke it up. Hoaglander couldn't touch the puck. He would have been offside. And now LeBois wrists it into the Vancouver zone. Hugh Suter took a tumble there. He's back on his feet. Chips the puck ahead to Garland, who couldn't get it out. Oilers set it up. Seth Griffin puts one in front. And LeBois had it bounce off his stick. Here's Cole. End of his shift. He wants to get to the bench. Gets the puck to Suter, who will facilitate the change with that chip in. 7 minutes into the second, 1-0 Oilers. Here's Soucy with a shot, knocked down, rebound, chopped wide. And that was Hoaglander at the end of his shift, trying to put the loose puck past the Oiler goaltender.
Started everything on that forecheck and then was able to move it all the way around and back to the point.
Hoaglander's having a good showing.
Yeah.
Here's Soucy, wrist shot, just missed. Peronik, Bluger looking in front. Gets a little pick. Peronik got away with that one. Here's Soucy to the side, put in front. Oman couldn't get the shot through. And the Oilers top of the puck and dump it around. It'll be picked up by Janmark. He's got three teammates with him. Chips one up the near side for Sutter, who just tips the puck down the boards.
It's the best run of play for the Canucks in this second period.
Here's Jack Studnicka. He gets the Oilers blue line and plays the puck in before heading to the bench. 8 minutes into the second. JT Miller watching Broberg as he played the puck ahead. Canucks break it up. Besser to Miller, and he flips one ahead for DiGiuseppe. Desharnais gets there first. Oilers play the puck up the boards. Kept into the right point by McWard, but here comes Philip Broberg. Skates through center and over the back of the line. Tried to play chip and chase, but he was stood up. Besser gets the puck nicely across to DiGiuseppe. Hughes racing to join him. It's a 2-on-1. Phil DiGiuseppe centers. Hughes scores! Could have played in the Labor Cup with those hands right out of midair. Quinn Hughes ties the game in one.
The captain gets him on the score sheet. DiGiuseppe has gone to the races and then realizes that Hughes is caught up. It's a saucer pass that has no landing gear and doesn't need it. Bunted into the net. Skinner can't get across in time. He's not going to stop that one. DiGiuseppe holds long enough, gets it over the sliding defenseman. And the hand eye. When he gets older, he'll play pickleball.
Hughes had the only goal of the overtime loss in Edmonton. The only Canuck goal in the 2-1 defeat. And he now has two of the three goals the Canucks have scored this preseason. DiGiuseppe and Besser assisting. They both have their first points of this exhibition campaign. Kuzmenko to Beauvillier. Three Canucks over the blue line. Beauvillier delays. Finds Kuzmenko across, and Cole's shot was blocked by Gleason. Here's Tyler Myers ahead for Andre Kuzmenko, who shovels the puck across to Ian Cole, and he drives it into the Edmonton zone. Pettersson making moves on the boards. Ran into Nugent Hopkins. Now Kuzmenko around for Carson Soucy. Into the middle, Heronik wrist shot, knocked down, loose puck. Oh, what a save! Skinner with the left pad as Kuzmenko tried to tuck that one short side along the ice, and Skinner kept it out. But he couldn't stop Quinn Hughes on a 2-on-1, and the game is tied at 1.
Well, Stuart Skinner ended last season as Edmonton's number one, but really started this season there. The Calder Finals was brilliant when he took over from Jack Campbell last season. But when the Oilers were balanced from the second round, many fingers, fairly or not, were pointed at the 24-year-old netminder. Fact of the matter is, no matter who wins the net, the Oilers will need both guys because GM Ken Holland says the number one guy's starts will be capped at about 50.
That's the exact number of appearances Skinner had last year, 29-14-5 in his 50 appearances. Campbell was excellent last year.
He was.
Hoaglander chips the puck into the Oilers zone. And he frees it up for Suter. Back to the line, sent to the right point to Hirona. Soucy at the left point, loads up, lets fly, and a blocker saved by Skinner. Oilers clear. Hirona back to pick up the puck in his own zone.
They are just tinkering with the defensive pairings throughout the game.
Here's Suter. DiGiuseppe back in for Pugh. Suter. Besser's there. Canucks are mid-change as Hughes walks across the slot of the backhand and there scores! He's having a night. Quinn Hughes with his second in a row and the Canucks have the lead.
Shoot more, get more. Forecheck has been profitable in the second period, and then give it to Hughes, he'll do the rest. This is knowing there's a screen. Skinner is confused on this one with traffic in front, and it just gets through. We've seen his slap shot. There's a backhand goal by the captain.
So he scores at 8:35, and then just under 2 minutes later, a minute 53 to be exact, he gets his second of the night and has turned the one goal deficit into a one goal advantage for the Vancouver Canucks. Here they come again. Miller after the puck of the court, bumps Janmark. DiGiuseppe there as well, trying to free up the puck with his skates, and he steals it back for Vancouver, only to be tied up by Janmark. Besser pokes it to the corner. Here's Miller behind the net. Reverses to the right point to Cole McWard. DiGiuseppe into the corner for Miller. Back up top, Brock Besser. Dumps the puck in deep again. Miller from behind the net. Puts the shoulder down to take on Evan Bouchard. Back to the line, Hughes, right point McWard. Wrist shot and glove by Skinner, who reaches out to snare that one. He'll take the whistle. Beaten twice in succession by Quinn Hughes. It's 2-1 Vancouver.
Well, Oilers have one. Hughes has two. Dragging people towards him and then just throw it towards the net. DiGiuseppe is good in front of the net to take away the eyes. You saw the reaction of Stuart Skinner, and there's the point totals. 76 tied with Miro Heiskanen. And the power play points says it all. Quinn Hughes logs a lot of ice time, rarely makes a mistake with the puck.
PDG has assists on both goals. DiGiuseppe set it up on the 2-on-1 for the first one, and he helped get Hughes the puck for the second one. Now he's going to go for a hat trick, maybe. Threw one on goal and winds up with the puck again in the near corner. Bouchard, Patterson, and in line up again to Mitchell. Bouchard, bodied by Beauvillier this time, as they announce the Hughes goal. Wayne Peterson brings the puck out. Pass to the middle, Hamblin just onside with the Oilers. Good job there to stay onside. Edmonton trying to keep the puck in the Vancouver zone, comes back to the blue line. Nurse leaves for James Hamblin. Now spinning with the puck is Lane Peterson. Xavier Borgo, there's a Vancouver penalty coming up. And a tripping call. Is it going to be Cole McWard again? His
yes.
Third trip to the box in this game, and the Oilers get their fourth power play.
Loose stick into the feet. Battling in the corner. There's the end result. Peterson was shifting to try to get away from McWard, and the blade was into the skates. Tough night for Cole McWard.
Fourth power play of the game. All four belong to the Oilers. And an opportunity to tie it up 12-12 into the second period. The Oilers come up with the puck off the draw. The Bluger, good job to pressure the line. Couldn't move it out. Good read by Bluger, and he's able to tip that one out to center ice.
One of the reasons the Oilers power play
was so good. We know the players from last season, but they were third in the NHL in faceoff percentage while on the power play. So they would start with it a lot, 63% of the time.
Bluger under pressure, but now Myers a chance to move the puck out. He's tied up, stays in the Vancouver zone. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. Puck thrown to the blue line. Seth Griffin to Evan Bouchard. Long shot deflected, just wide. As Connor Brown tipped that one down and dragged it back a bit. Canucks clear, and the Oilers will start again from their own zone with a minute to go on the penalty to Cole McWard.
This game, Demko, in this period hasn't been as busy.
He's only faced two shots. Go. Canucks have had nine on Stuart Skinner, and Hughes has scored twice. Peterson plays chip and chase. Took a little hook from Soucy, then he was upended by Carson Soucy. Oilers dig for the puck. Hronek tried to check his man. Evander Kane gets it, dumps it back. No! Just held onside by Darnell Nurse. Peterson. Pettersson came back and belted it. A couple big hits for Elias Pettersson this period. There's a shot stopped, and the rebound jammed wide by Evander Kane. Soucy gets the loose puck and dumps it down the ice.
And then Peterson went back at Pettersson. A little bit of a snarl in the game of Elias Pettersson in this game.
That hit Pettersson just threw reminded me of the one that Gilbert had on Nils Höglander in Calgary. Uh-oh. As that's going to be a penalty against Tyler Meyer. No, they say it deflected. Never mind. I thought he shot it right out. In any event, Pettersson being physical, and his Canucks lead by one. Seattle, Texas wrap up the regular season tomorrow. I believe mathematically Seattle is still alive, but their result tonight did punch Toronto's ticket to the postseason.
Demko ready for this one, and it's passed on the blocker side, deflected in front by Connor Brown, and Elias Pettersson taking down a former teammate.
I didn't do a very good job explaining the baseball there a little bit.
Well, it's
Seattle,
a little bit complicated.
It depends what Houston does and then Seattle. But we do know that because of the result down I-5 tonight with Texas winning, that Toronto has officially clinched.
That's what you should have started with,
I guess. But I was trying to promote the game to watch tomorrow, so.
Well, it's still compelling.
It's a conundrum.
It is.
That puck went out of play. They'll face off right at center with 5:34 remaining in the second period.
Coaching staff to elite defensemen and what they do at the NHL level or did with Gonchar and Foote.
Here's Garland center. Höglander was going to the net. Now Garland behind the goal. Höglander. Connor Garland threw one across. Here's Cole. Slid one in front of the Oilers. Collapsed back to knock that away. Garland gets the puck again. Tyler Myers. Now Garland couldn't take it cleanly, and the puck comes outside the line to center.
It's a smart play by a forward to go up to the blue line. You just lose coverage, but Garland, heavy pass. He was about to handle it before he had it cleanly.
Miller line back out for Vancouver. Myers breaks up that pass at center. Here's Phil DiGiuseppe. Sent one across. Besser checked just inside the line. Tyler Myers inside his own blue line. Plays one ahead. Oilers send it the other way with 4:20 now remaining in the second period. Canucks leading 2-1. Quinn Hughes, both goals, both of them here in the middle frame after Adam Ernie had given the Oilers a 1-0 lead late in the first. Hughes upended. Wound up giving the puck away. Could have been an opportunity maybe for the first Oiler penalty. Now Hughes up the left wing. Pettersson. Referee getting his way there as he tried to move in on the left wing. Here's Besser. Leaves for Pettersson. Hughes at the right point. Richard and I think hit the post after catching the goaltender. Might have been deflected in front after Hughes let fly from the right point.
A couple of times Skinner has created his own issues, putting both hands in front of his chest, not being able to catch the puck. Instead, it goes awry.
Pettersson tips that puck into the Oilers' zone. And he anticipated well. They're headed towards the path of the pass. Kuzmenko long wrist shot, and that changed direction. It went wide of the goal. Back comes Nugent Hopkins up the left wing of Andrew Kane, checked by Philip Hronek. Soucy tried to move the puck ahead. That was broken up. Here's Nurse into the corner. Nugent Hopkins up the boards towards Kane. Broken up by Soucy, who finds Bluger, and he leaves for Philip Hronek. Plays the puck gently ahead. Bluger giving chase. Oilers send it the other way. Bavillier plays it offside, but the Canucks will change.
Offside!
They're still offside because the door to the bench is inside the blue line. But the Oilers make that a moot point by moving the puck ahead and over the Vancouver blue line. Cole under pressure loses the puck. Here's a sharp angle shot. Borgo put it wide. Bouchard threw that one off a leg. Nurse hustles after the puck. Stanika tried to hit him along the boards. Now Jack Stanika gets the loose puck and he plays it out to center ice.
Talked about that in the opener for him. Just get the puck, move your feet to get it out of the zone rather than trying to jam it up the boards and maybe extend the shift for the Oilers.
Bluger hit with a penalty here to Bouchard, who doesn't like the call. Bluger was kind of hunched over when he got hit. I don't know if it's going to be a boarding call or what, but the interference are going to call because the puck was up ahead of Bluger. And it's the first penalty of the game for Edmonton.
Could have had one earlier, sticking to the feet of Hughes, but yeah, poking it and then almost into the side of the curved glass.
Off the side of the net, that Hughes chance, as he was bidding for a hat-trick goal. But on the replay, you can see why they called that interference, as the puck was about 5-8 feet ahead of them and they were chasing after it.
See what this power play comes up with for the Canucks.
Canucks 1-for-12 in the preseason thus far. That one goal, a Hughes goal against the Oilers Wednesday in Edmonton.
Yeah, and it was a hard wrist shot that went off the players in the penalty box. Bouchard at the front of the net.
Good stick handling in traffic from Ben Gleason there to protect the puck and eventually slide it down the ice. Canucks will start the power play from deep in their own end. Hughes, nice move to get around Brandon Sutter. Leaves for Besser, now Pettersson. Fan on his pass attempt for Miller. And Hughes regroups at his own blue line. Hughes faked the pass ahead for Miller. Here's Besser carrying it. Miller on the left wing. Canucks set up. Hughes at the blue line. Kuzmenko. Pettersson. Here's Pettersson to the side of the net. Besser banks one back to Hughes. Cross to Miller. Puts one in front. Kuzmenko got high stick as he tried to tip that one through. I think it was the linesman who blew the whistle.
He was looking for a deflection to the front of the net. Linen got the stick up.
Neither referee had an arm in the air, but it looked like the linesman stopped play.
Miller looking for the stick. And 80 in white right up to the chops. So they're going to confer.
And it's a 2-minute minor being assessed, I believe, by Steve Cazari, and I'm told by Griff McDonald as we get the call. So it is a 2-minute minor for Heising. Griff McDonald, stats man extraordinaire, says it actually was Steve Cazari who stopped play, not the linesman. But neither official had his arm in the air. They do wind up calling a penalty.
5-on-3 for 1:02. This is an excellent opportunity for the Canucks. Their top power play unit was out there, but this is a long enough rest because of the blown play, and then to confer linesmen, referees, and the usual suspects for the Canucks out on this power play. Almost.
Canucks had a two-man advantage in the last game with Edmonton, but that one was only for 20 seconds.
Yeah, they're taking Kuzmenko off. But he's being instructed to be right at the bench, and Garland, who replaced him, is probably going to help on the faceoff and then scamper to the bench.
Kuzmenko ready to jump over the boards.
It's because he was injured on the play, and it blowed the play down that he'd have to leave the ice. Sorry for using blowed. Blew the play down.
Yes. My mother, the English teacher, would be appalled. Here's Pettersson, one timer, he ripped it wide. 95 miles an hour on that one time. Hughes. Miller wanted to load up for a shot, I think, but the puck didn't stay with him. Two-man advantage continues. Miller across. Pettersson blocked by Grober. Besser wins a battle for the puck behind the net. 35 seconds to go in the period. Miller shoots, blocked. Kuzmenko up for real. Besser couldn't put it home. Miller feeds back to Hughes. Under 30 seconds to go in the period. Here's Pettersson. Quinn Hughes. JT Miller back to Hughes. He shoots. Skinner the save as he swallowed that one up with 20 seconds to go in the period.
Brock Besser was just stationed off to the blocker side and got his stick down in time. After the Miller shot was blocked, swatted away, and it's just off the side of the net. Off his knee and then off the bottom of the stick. And I like this version of Quinn Hughes, the shooter.
Well, I was heading into last season, he said he'd taken note of how many more shots Roman Josi had than he did. That was 2 years ago, and then worked on the notion of shooting more and also working on his shot prior to last season. And early in this preseason, we're certainly seeing the results and a little bit of a different type of player. Here's Pettersson in across. Kuzmenko hit the side of the net, and that'll do it for period number two. As the Oilers are now down to just a one-man disadvantage. But what a period for Quinn Hughes, who scored twice and had opportunities to add the hat trick goal. His team leads by one heading to the third. Martin and Faisal coming up again. Murph with more from Ian McIntyre and Satshaw. 2-1 Canucks lead after 40 minutes. Canucks with the lead, and they'll have some power play time to start the period, just under a minute remaining in the Oilers penalty. We talked about Quinn Hughes in the first intermission because he was so dynamic in that opening period. Now we got to talk about him again because he was even more dynamic in the second, and he's got goals to show for it.
He does, and I think that he really relishes being the captain of this hockey team and wants to elevate his play. It was an elevated pass and it's knocked into the air, and this is what he does so well. Shields the puck. This one goes through traffic off the post and into the net. Kind of easy. But how do you defend him? If you go at him, he'll go around you. If you give him time, he'll find somebody else. And the mantra of shooting the puck more. This gets deflected. And this next one will get swallowed up. But as I said before, I like this version of Quinn Hughes, and I think he is going to open more eyes throughout the season with his play in both ends of the ice.
He's out to quarterback the power play to start the third. There you see Niemelainen in the penalty box, just under a minute remaining in his minor penalty. That was for the high stick on Kuzmenko, who's also out there as part of the power play. Canucks 0-for-1, working on the remainder of power play number two. They had a two-man advantage for 62 seconds, but couldn't convert, and now we're having trouble getting the clock up to 20, I think, and that's why the delay here. Steve Cazari over at the timekeeper's bench.
Just plug it back in. On the power play, we saw Kuzmenko and Besser kind of trading spots, where Besser was near the front of the net looking for the tips, and Kuzmenko was the bumper. And Rick Tocchet had said on his power play, he doesn't want guys to be static. Movement is the best way to stretch the penalty killers out. So I think there's going to be some lot of interchanging for the Canucks on their power play. The puck will start on one side, get taken to the other. Guys moving around. You got to know other spots rather than just kind of quote unquote your spot. Like, I'm on a half wall guy, I'm not going anywhere else. Nope, there's got to be more movement.
They continue to work on the clock here. I've worked in television and radio long enough and been around enough engineers to know you just unplug it and plug it back in, and then it resets.
Yeah, or...
And that's how you fix anything.
I mean, if you had the Fonz here, you could just give it a...
It was a timely reference.
Just punch it. Or we could do what they do in Europe. You start from zero when you work the clock up.
That's right. I remember when we first started working together and you were just so befuddled by figuring out the time of goals and penalties in that first season we worked together on radio.
Right.
Because the clock was going in the other direction.
Yeah, well, the European direction. So it's time that's been played, right? If you look up at the clock in Europe and it's 4:53, well, you've played for 4 minutes and 53 seconds of that period, where, of course, it's the opposite, or they'd like it to be if they can get the 20 on the clock to start this period.
They're working out the kinks. It's all new. The scoreboard itself is absolutely beautiful. It is giant, and it is very clear, very high def. I don't even think they call it high def anymore. That's so many years ago, but you see the boards for the fans sitting down low on the underside so they can see, in case they're too low and too angled to see the sides of it.
A lot of improvements here at Rogers Arena. Some nice new seats behind the benches. Testing of the horn, it still works. The Oilers,
okay, we got, is it good, was the power play time up there the whole time? I didn't even notice, because that seemed to be like a development in a positive sense.
Well, the in-arena clock now is getting close. I think they have it worked up.
Oh, we got it. Players 1956
on the ice are just skating around to keep the legs warm, and the Oilers are actually staying overnight here in Vancouver. No, sorry, they're flying to Seattle tonight after the game and staying a day in Seattle before their next game. Some team bonding. Usually you go right back to your home city. Instead, they're going to go south of the border.
All right, we're at 20 minutes. And that's the 15 minutes of fame they probably didn't want.
Right. I thought you had the manual.
It appears we're closer to being ready to go here on the third period, which has been delayed because of some issues as they learn how to work this beautiful new piece of state-of-the-art equipment. Did they take my advice and just turn it on and off?
Just really give it a little tap on the side. Or maybe it's just the batteries are down.
Cheech would be totally sympathetic to them because he still has a VCR at home that flashes 12.
Not a Betamax?
We're underway. Canucks are on the power play. They lead 2-1. Elias Pettersson tripped. It'll be another penalty, this one to Brandon Sutter. And it'll be another two-man advantage for the Canucks, this one for 37 seconds.
Miller with the drop pass, trying to draw people towards him, and then with speed for Pettersson to the middle. Tripped over the stick of former Canuck Brandon Sutter. And another 5-on-3, this one not as long, 37 seconds. And we'll see if the Canucks, via Hughes on the power play, can extend their lead.
Third two-man advantage they've had in two games against the Oilers. First one was 20 seconds. The one earlier tonight, a minute two. There's a shot right off the faceoff by Pettersson, and he ripped that one. Another one at 95 miles an hour, and the Oilers clear the zone. Hughes brings the puck ahead. Leaves for Pettersson, who protects down the boards. Hughes in front. Kuzmenko shoots. He scores. Seconds into the third, Andre Kuzmenko on a power play makes it 3-1.
A Bally blast from the slot. Canucks are able to gain the zone because Pettersson shields the puck and then moves it. That allows Kuzmenko to get completely open one stick handle, and he's got a heavy shot just over the left pad, ticks off that and into the net. Canucks power play comes to life, 3-1.
And they're still on the power play because the first penalty had not yet expired. So the Canucks 1-for-2 with a man advantage go to work on number three with Sutter still in the penalty box for Edmonton. Hughes with his third point of the game. He's got two goals and an assist. And the Canucks will try to set up and look for more. They have the second unit power play out there. Garland knocked that down, but with a high stick, and the faceoff will come outside the blue line with a minute 19 to go on the Vancouver power play.
It's obviously easier to gain the zone on the power play on a 5-on-3, but what drew the penalty was the entry on the 5-on-4. And Quinn Hughes is racking up the points. There's the turning of the body by Patterson, and now we're going to see if they can't get another power play goal in this remaining time.
Arona, the lone defenseman on this unit. Here's Pugh Suter. Gets a return pass. Able to poke it free to Sladniku. Attacks from the side, and a shot went over top of the crossbar. Arona to Suter. Pugh Suter's pass blocks. Puck loose in the corner. Oilers work it free to Nima Leinen. His clearing attempt knocked down by Garland, and the Canucks maintain control in the Oilers zone. Connor Garland, 40 seconds to go on the Vancouver power play. Garland at the blue line. Suter on the right wing boards. Banks one back, but that's going to escape the zone as Hronek couldn't get there in time. Philip Hronek skates the puck in again, puts it to the middle off the stick of Bovilia. He then tried to steal it back. His pass picked off by Gleason, and he clears the puck out to center. Here's Tyler Myers. As the Canucks get two defensemen out there with just 10 seconds remaining in the man advantage, Myers fires the puck in from center. Nurse shoots it into the back of the bench. Ooh, I might have caught Adam Foot there. As that puck went right sailing over the boards. And I think it hit Foot right in front of Sergei Gonchar.
Yeah, the players, they cover themselves up, but the coaches, they don't have the luxury of a shield or equipment. Adam Foote's gotten in the way of shots before, though.
He has.
I'll tell you this, as nasty as he was on the ice is as nice as he is off the ice.
Seriously, yeah.
It's unreal.
Yeah, this is a coaching staff that through and through, you know. We talk about Mike Yeo and Sergei Gonchar, Rick Tocchet. They have all kinds of time for us. I guess we're going to throw in Dylan Crawford and Greg Hood as well. They're probably listening as they sit in their video bunker.
There's Studnicka. Just a simple play, shot towards the net. If it's there, take it. And I think that's what he's done most in his games, is the simple thing. Get the feet moving, get up ice, chip it ahead, chase it down. I mean, if he gets some goals, that's gravy or whipped cream, depending on your meal.
Canucks control in the Oilers zone. Edmonton's back to full strength. Canucks 1-for-3 on the power play. Bouchard. Glove down by Myers. Nurse gets the puck, banks it ahead. Intercepting is Cole, and here's Niels Omark. Myers against the grain with that back pass to Teddy Bluger. Knocked off his stick by Lane Peterson. Oman steals the puck back. Bluger pressured by Nurse. Oman comes in to dig for the puck. 3 minutes into the third. Oilers scored the game's first goal. Canucks have scored three unanswered since. Besser takes that puck off the boards. Works his way in on the left wing. Feeds back to Susie. Right point, Hronek. Wrist shot deflected. As I think Miller got a piece of that one. Could have missed the target. Hronek knocked his man down. Besser shoots. Skinner read that well. Out to challenge and make the save. And he gets the whistle as Desharnais and Miller joust in the goal crease. And in comes DiGiuseppe to join the fun.
Well, the Oilers need to bring some energy. And a scrum after the whistle sometimes drags other players into the fight. But a turnover and then a scoring chance. DiGiuseppe is Going to make sure nobody else is going to go after Miller after he was taking care of himself. Off the glass, there's the body. And the loose puck for DiGiuseppe over to Bessa, who is ready to shoot. Skinner, no, he thinks he has it. And then a bit of a stick fight there. And DiGiuseppe getting in the middle.
Suter comes out to take this face off against Ryan Nugent-Hopkins to the right of Stuart Skinner. Shots after one period were 14-5 for Edmonton. They're now 21-17 in favor of the Canucks, who had a little more purpose and urgency to their game when they came out to play period number two. Nils Höglander had that one bounce over a stick. Oilers look to take advantage. Kane shoots. Demko the same. First shot he's faced this period. Here's Nugent-Hopkins. Watched by Garland. Connor Brown backhands the puck to the near side. Desharnais lets it go to the blue line. Kane fanned on it. And here comes Garland. Höglander going to the net on the other side. Garland drops back. Quinn Hughes cuts wide around the net. Puts one in front. Suter couldn't jam it home. Höglander banging away. Here's Garland. Checked by Kane. Suter shovels one back to McWard. Now Hughes. Cole McWard. Wrist shot. And that hit a body in front. Höglander, after the loose puck, kicks it up to his stick. Nice reversal to Suter. Hugh Suter. I think he was trying to go back to Hughes. There's another Edmonton penalty coming up. And it's going to be against Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. A cross-checking call. And the Canucks are going to get their fourth straight power play in this game. And all of a sudden, the man advantages are four apiece.
Some good pressure by the Canucks. And Nugent-Hopkins takes down Höglander with that cross check. It's too high on the letters. And this is Hughes. As he's looking right to the front of the net. Hugh Suter just can't get his stick on. All that was created because Garland came into the zone and realized it was not a defenseman he's up against. It was Evander Kane. So he waited long enough. The Canucks were in the middle of a change. And all that offensive prowess brings about a power play.
Canucks 1-for-3 with a man advantage. And they get the puck to Pettersson to begin. Back to Hughes. Here's Miller with room. He shoots. Skinner the same. As JT Miller leaned into that one and got pretty good velocity on the wrist shot. Skinner there to stop him.
And once again, Pettersson's able to shield the puck. Still looks over his left shoulder. Then he knows Hughes is going to be there. All eyes on Hughes, allows Miller to get open. Unfortunately, the players were on the glove side, so nobody in the shooting lane, and Miller can't get it high enough over the blocker. Skinner able to swallow it.
Oilers send the puck around. Pettersson keeps it in. Fires across for Hughes. Kuzmenko protecting the puck from Nurse. Miller after it. Nurse did well to work it free, but then the clearing attempt by Sutter was no good. Hughes kept it in with the skate. Miller across. Besser. Back to Pettersson, takes a look, lets it go, he scores! Elias Pettersson picked his spot, and he hit it to make it 4-1.
That was a sweetie from Petey on the power play. Canucks continue to keep the puck alive. Walking in, waiting, using the screen. Skinner is down the whole time, and it's up over his glove. Two defensemen trying to play goalie. Goalie couldn't play goalie, and the Canucks make it 4-1.
Pettersson at 5:08. Canucks are 2-for-4 on the power play. He's got a goal and an assist now. Besser and Miller, the helpers on this one. Brock Besser has a couple of assists in the game. Pardon me, three assists in the game. Here's Höglander trying to throw the puck in front. That's grabbed by Skinner, and he'll take the whistle for the faceoff in the Oilers' zone. Murph.
We'll get ready to celebrate a fantastic birthday with Finn, presented by Save On Foods. Book your Finn birthday now. Canucks.com/FinnBirthdays. Receive a free cake voucher, $25 gift card from Save On Foods, and some extra goodies.
One more look at the latest from Elias Pettersson, kind of using Janmark as a screen. And when he has time to pick his spot, it's tough for pretty much every goalie in this league.
Yeah, and Skinner didn't help himself. He was on his knees before the shot came.
We're just sorting out where Besser's other assist came. It was on the second Hughes goal. They changed the first assist from Garland to Besser. It was probably just a clerical error with someone seeing a right-hand shot in a single-digit number. 4-1 Canucks lead as we approach the six-minute mark of the third period. Here's Lane Peterson. Broberg with a shot that didn't get through. Puck given away by Bluger, and he knew immediately. Looked to the heavens after throwing that one to the middle. But he gets to atone for it here as he collects the loose puck. Skates it ahead and chips it into the corner. Now he's in a battle with Broberg behind the net. Oilers free it up. And Peterson sends one ahead. The relay for Desharnais was out of his reach. Cole McWard hit the referee trying to play it around for Hughes. And the Oilers look to take advantage. Here's Ernie with a shot. He missed on the short side. McWard and Ernie head towards the puck. Stadnicka gets it. And he chips it off the boards and down the ice for an icing call and a faceoff in the Vancouver zone. Canadians and Leafs duke it out Monday in Toronto as the NHL preseason continues. Catch all the action at 4 Pacific, 7 Eastern on Sportsnet.
You took a snapshot of this lineup for the Canucks. I know there's still jobs to be won. Some players that have had NHL pedigree that aren't in the lineup tonight. But this is a roster that would could probably play this season somewhere along the line. If an injury here or there, like every player would, you know, this lineup would be indicative, and it's looking good.
Shot attempt kicked away by Hughes, delayed offside, and Sutter touches the puck, so the whistle sounds, and we'll take a break. Canucks have added two more here in the third, both on power plays, and it's 4-1 Vancouver.
It's been a pretty busy 7 months for Teddy Bluger. The Latvian was dealt from Pittsburgh to Vegas at deadline, went on to win the Stanley Cup, of course, with the Golden Knights. He took the cup to Latvia, dined his favorite dish out of it. Probably didn't have to make his mom clean up, but he did, and then he literally stopped traffic in Riga carrying hockey's greatest prize down the street, and of course signing with the Canucks when free agency started.
Whirlwind year. Ending the way anybody who plays this sport dreams of. Pettersson upended in the corner. Connor Brown in a battle with Elias Pettersson. Hronek's there for Vancouver as well. Nugent Hopkins had the puck momentarily. Now it's Carson Soucy. Pass knocked away by Evander Kane. And Nugent Hopkins backhands the puck back into the Vancouver zone. Kane threw a hit on Soucy. And Brown keeps the puck in. Dumps it to the near corner. Soucy there first. Chips it free for Hronek, who delays to buy himself some space. And now Soucy up ahead, out of the reach. And they're going to say Bouchard had a play on that one. So no icing.
Well, he kept the Oilers to the outside. You had Kane and Nurse trying to get physical. Again, this Oilers team not with their two stars, McDavid and Draisaitl. And I was talking about the makeup of this Canucks team. I realize that Edmonton is not at its best.
Just past the 8 minute mark of the third. JT Miller fires back. Ian Cole down to Brock Besser. Cole, one timer, tipped in by Phil DiGiuseppe. Skinner looked to the referee, thinking he might have been a high stick. But DiGiuseppe with the tip out of midair makes it 5-1.
Great hand eye in the right position at the front of the net. As the Canucks gain the zone. And Besser picks up another point. And there's DiGiuseppe. That looked a little high, but it's where the puck connects with the stick and the crossbar as your
height. I think he brought it down.
Yeah. Play on.
So he gets the fifth unanswered goal for the Canucks. Another assist for Brock Besser, his fourth of the game. Cole and Besser assisting on this one. And at 8:16, the Canucks increase their lead to 4. DiGiuseppe with a goal and 2 assists in this game. In his regular season career, he's had 1 3-point game. Here come the Oilers, and they score. As they answer that one right back, Raphael Lavoie with a wrist shot past Thatcher Demko to make it 5-2.
Lavoie can really shoot the puck. Led Bakersfield in goals. Big man. And lean into the stick, 2-on-1. And this is past the blocker, as this time Myers is playing pass. And Lavoie rifles this up top. You like to have a stronger shift after you score a goal, but Oilers aren't going away anytime soon.
So they get that one 26 seconds after DiGiuseppe made it 5-1. And an offside whistle stops play at the Oiler blue line. DiGiuseppe at 8:16, Lavoie right after at 8:42.
Well, he was at the front of the net looking for the screen. And got the stick up and then brought it down.
It's close.
It is close.
It's almost like, I'd say, exactly crossbar height when it made contact, but it certainly started high, and that was probably what caught the eye of Stuart Skinner.
Well, the thing about being at the front of the net and trying to tip pucks, it's easier to bring your stick high to low to tip than it is low to high. So you get it up high and then you bring it down. Started pretty high, but got it there.
Stanika tried to get one on goal. Puck ricochets out to center. And Quinn Hughes takes control in his own zone. Cole McWard ahead for Niels Omark. And Stanika helps the puck deep into the Oilers' end. Skinner out of his net. He'll scamper back. As Borgo takes a stiff check from Jack Stanika. Oilers slide the puck into the Vancouver zone. Demko plays to the corner. Cut off there by Hamblin, but Soucy will try the near side. He sends one to the Oiler blue line. Brad Malone dumps the puck the other way. And Demko will play that to the side. Whoa, he meant to play to the side. He missed it. Griffith was there. He missed it. And now Demko back in position to make a save off Lavoie again. Preseason is time to work out the kicks.
Yeah. It looked like he just wanted to poke it, missed it, and kind of froze everybody.
Beauvillier sends the puck around. Myers down from the right point. Pettersson behind the net. Beauvillier trying to get open for a pass. Takes it. Back in for Pettersson. Myers is in front. Pass came towards the front. Was broken up. And the Oilers backhand the puck down. Cole being pursued by Griffith. And Demko steers the puck behind the net. Cole took a tumble, and the Oilers, Malone was there, but the Canucks quickly back to break things up. 9.5 to go in the third. Canucks 5, the Oilers 2. Beauvillier back for Kuzmenko. Plays the puck up the board, skates on it himself. Trying to settle the puck as he stick handles through center. Check from behind by Brandon Sutter. Janmark put the puck to the middle. Another attempt to move it up. This time he does, and Quinn Hughes tracks back for Vancouver. Backhands one to Brock Besser. Cross for JT Miller, who slides the puck in. DiGiuseppe ties up Ben Gleason. Ernie gets the puck. It's off his stick right to Besser. Sends it across. Hughes cuts wide. Shoots. Oh, he had some room on the short side, but the puck winds up ricocheting over the glass. He's denied a hat trick. Besser denied a fifth assist. It stays 5-2 Vancouver.
Goals. Besser has the assist. DiGiuseppe has the work shovel in this one. This is on the penalty kill. Just gets it towards the net. Gets the whistle. Sosa pass for a helper to Hughes. Tap out of the air and tap in. And then just a simple play. Move it across. Force the goalie to make a save. Here's the goal. Unattended at the front of the net. Stick kind of low. Deflected down. Quite the night for Phil.
I'd like to put a bow on a topic that I was so expertly disseminating earlier. And this is directed mostly to our New York audience. Apparently the Astros won, so the Mariners are now eliminated. Okay? Because I've clearly been showing my baseball chops today. Here's Nurse. His pass disrupted. Would have been offside, so DiGiuseppe let the puck go. Darnell Nurse. Went after his own shooting. Worked out perfectly. Demko came out, realized he was in no man's land, and Nurse just couldn't beat him.
And a couple of foibles by Demko, and he leaves the blue paint.
Here's Evander Kane. We're under 8 minutes now to go in the third. Trying to wrap around, and Demko had that covered. DiGiuseppe pokes the puck to Connor Garland. He gets to center and plays it into the Oilers' end. Nugent Hopkins hoists the puck out. Hughes turns it center. Being watched by Borgo. Jack Stadnicka. Nicely through for Teddy Bluger, who banks the puck into the Oilers zone. Probert got the boards. Bluger broke that up. Hamlin to Lane Peterson, and he backhands the puck into Vancouver territory. Hughes watched by Xavier Borgo. One off the glass and out to center. Leeson chips it free, and Borgo sends it back into the Vancouver zone. 7 minutes remaining in the third. McGuire got warned that Leeson was stepping up, able to throw on the brakes and slide the puck in deep.
This continuous play really plays into the hands of the Canucks. The Oilers really not mounting much, and then just time winding off the clock.
Might mount something here. Gleason with a shot that changed direction. Demko was leaning left as he watched it go wide to his right. Kuzmenko to Myers. Ooh, Broberg hung a leg on him, it looked like.
Yeah, missed.
Kuzmenko centers the puck. Pettersson couldn't get a shot away. Now he does on the backhand. And a glove save by Skinner.
Skinner will have to be aware of the couple of spin plays. First Kuzmenko towards Pettersson. Zip and pinball, and on the backhand trying to get it over the glove. Fourth year for Stuart Skinner.
Malone right out of this faceoff. And Lavoie in to take it against J.T. Miller, who is in turn waved out. So it'll be Lavoie against Brock Besser now. Couple righties, and the Oilers win control. Desharnais couldn't get it past Besser. DiGiuseppe pass was into the skates of Miller, whose pass of his own went off the skate note down the ice. Tyler Myers head towards Besser. Oilers get in the way of that. Ian Cole slides the puck to Tyler Myers. No icing because Besser was being tied up by Malone. Under 6 minutes to go in the third. Dave Metchett. Both these teams play their next games against Seattle. Edmonton will be at Climate Pledge Arena on Monday. Canucks will be taking on the Kraken Wednesday in Abbotsford at the Abbotsford Center. Garland in, drop pass, Hoglander back for Garland. Round the net, banks it to Soucy, and he sends it back in deep. Garland into the corner for Hoglander. Spinning on Sutter, spins again, chips the puck back down below the goal line. Desharnais there to send it ahead, and Sutter is able to move it outside the line. 5 minutes to go in the third. Canucks 5 and the Oilers 2.
It's been a game where the Canucks got better as it went on. And the offense, most of it coming here in the third.
Here's Nugent Hopkins with a sharp angle back. And then he put it in front, and that could have gone in off McWard. It bounced the other way. And the Canucks move the puck to neutral ice. Bluger dumps it in deep. Bouchard. Kept in by the Canucks. Bluger down for Studnick, who braced himself and bounced off the check of Bouchard. Now Studnick tried to sweep the puck to the blue line while falling down. Oilers break that up, and the puck is out to center. Shot in by Evander Kane.
Well, none of the breakouts from the Oilers have been clean. Everything's a backhand desperation off the glass, or just trying to push it out of the zone.
Kuzmenko into the Edmonton end, working on Kane. Beauvillier into the corner for Ian Cole. Pass blocked, keeps after it. Pettersson covering for Cole at the blue line. Puck is punched out, and here's Kane. Checked by Tyler Myers. Kuzmenko to Pettersson. Turning inside the blue line, he backhands the puck to the corner. Lane Peterson finds Broberg in space. And he gains the red and backhands the puck through. Borgo's after it, into the crease, Demko! And to make a save there on Hamlin, who was following up and tried to flip that one over the pad.
Hey, just trusted his instincts, and instead of lunging forward, just stayed positional and was able to get that off that left pad.
Cole waiting for a change to be completed. Finds Miller. And he saw Peterson there waiting to hit him. 3 minutes to go in the third. Borgo chips the puck to the far side. Peterson's there. Hronek's on him, so DiGiuseppe takes the puck. Sped back to the left point. Soucy, Miller, weak one timer. That was blocked in front by Gleason, and he clears the puck out. Besser. Of his shift, he dumps the puck in and heads to the bench.
Yeah, let's keep rolling those lines, and the Canucks have certainly wrestled this game away from Edmonton.
Griffith sends the puck to the corner. McWard hit there by Lavoie. Hoaglander went back with it. Garland under pressure, chips the puck free to Hoaglander, spun his way up the boards, and in tandem with Garland, they move it up to Pugh Suter. Hoaglander racing to join him. Suter down the boards for Hoaglander. Near side, out of the reach of Garland. But there's a penalty coming up. Elbowing call. And is it Bouchard headed to the box for Edmonton as the Canucks get a fifth consecutive power play after the Oilers had the first four of the game.
Hoaglander was protecting the puck. And I wondered if he was going to get fancy or play it safe, which is what the coaching staff would prefer. And he's able to get it behind the net. Tried to then get it to Garland. But I mentioned Vancouver took this game into their favor. It was a 1-0 Edmonton lead late first. Here's the battle on the wall, and then that's to the head of Garland. Bouchard complaining about it, but the Canucks will get their power play to perhaps usher out this game.
And they do put their number one unit out. Hughes to Pettersson. He shoots, and that went off the stick. He broke the stick, in fact, of Adam Ernie. And then just tossed it away, and looked like he almost hit his goaltender with. Here's Kuzmenko. Hughes, who has two goals in this game. Cross to Pettersson. Wrist shot kicked out, loose puck cleared the line, and off the glove of Hughes and out. Miller. Pass through for Kuzmenko. Puts it back to Miller, across to Pettersson. Back for Quinn Hughes. Pettersson. Hughes. And his pass for Pettersson. Tipped away by Connor Brown, who now pressures Pettersson inside the blue line. Minute to go. And Hughes got to that puck ahead of Darnell Nurse. Launches one ahead for Brock Besser, who feeds back to Quinn Hughes. Besser forced offside by Nurse, who came back, and that causes the whistle at the Edmonton blue line. Murph.
Toyota Junior Trainer is back. Andrew Child now for an exclusive opportunity to be the junior trainer at a Canucks game. Well, they'll get this behind-the-scenes look at how the Vancouver Canucks and trainers prepare for a game along with a Toyota Junior Trainer prize pack.
Pat O'Neill. Let Max Stewart be the main man on the trip to Edmonton.
And he's one of the best.
Oilers shorthanded, clear the puck down the ice, 40 seconds remaining. And I think someone's been thrown out of the game here. Oh, whoa, Darren Hayes just went after Beauvillier. Got him right in the chops, it looked like.
Yeah.
And now Studnicka and Ernie in a wrestling match. And a little ground and pound for them.
Now Suter and Gleason. On that last whistle, Brock Besser had the puck at the blue line, and it was a delayed call as they kind of don't separate here. And Darnell Nurse hit him, I thought, late. Besser brushed it off. Nurse continued on, but
I think this started with Ernie on Studnicka, and I think Ernie was the one getting tossed. And then it was Desharnais that went right at Beauvillier. And Desharnais now being ushered off by Bevan Mills, the linesman, but not before he gets his Rory McIlroy in this parking lot, Rory.
Yeah, this is off the faceoff. A couple of cross checks. And then this is dangerous. I mean, to the face. I wonder if it's the glove holding the stick. Still doesn't feel good. Darnay is heated, and then Ernie comes in and grabs Studnicka. So for a team that's going to meet each other at the very start of the season, and Tocchet in the days that he played,
that's Evander Kane he's jawing with.
Yeah, could keep a game from getting out of hand. Couple of exhibition games against the Oilers, opening the season against the Oilers. Get your tickets.
So this game, which was 40 seconds away from being done, taking a little longer as they sort through the penalties.
Get everything right. This period was delayed at the start because of a clock malfunction. And now the referees have to deem who stays in and who gets tossed. Steve Cazari, the veteran. Tocchet's got to be proud of his team, the work ethic. And he was talking about board battles, puck battles, being stronger along the wall, since Seattle was the better team last game in that regard. I think the Canucks have been much better to a man in this game, in that getting to pucks, staying with it. Jay Woodcroft trying to get things figured out as well.
As you would expect, it would appear both coaches saw what unfolded on the ice through slightly different lenses.
Yeah.
Ben Gullickson, ex of the Canucks bench. And Mike Yeo, part of Rick Tocchet's staff, as they get the explanations. And
well, a couple of power play goals in this game for the Canucks. They were 11th overall on the power play this past season, 22.7%.
At this point, they have a double minor up to, I believe, Desharnais.
That would be the cross check to the face of Beauvillier.
And I think that's it, aside from the 47 seconds that was remaining in the elbowing penalty to Evan Bouchard. It's Janmark who's serving the penalty, but I don't think he's the one who's been assessed the penalty.
Another 5-on-3. In this case, a 4-on-3.
So there are other penalties, obviously. But with 39 seconds left in a 5-2 game, I'm not going to expend too much energy trying to figure out what they are.
It is 5-on-3.
No.
No.
Kuzmenko's just coming to the penalty box. He's serving the whoever got assessed a Vancouver penalty. Probably Jack Studnicka. And we're set to go with a two-man advantage for the Canucks. The fourth one they've had against the Oilers this preseason. They scored on one earlier. That was Kuzmenko. Goal again. 3-1 Vancouver. Myers has the puck in the blue line. 15 seconds to go in the game. JT Miller. Canucks not attacking with any purpose, right? Miller just keeping it to the outside, and he might just continue that as time winds down in this one. And the Canucks content with the first win in the preseason as they give up the opening goal to come back and knock off the Oilers 5-2 at Rogers Arena. Quinn Hughes had a couple.
Canucks got better as the game went on. The power play came to life in the third, and even though they haven't scored first yet in an exhibition game, they get their first win as the home team.
Thatcher Demko and his teammates celebrate their first win of the preseason. They got a couple more to go, and the last one against Calgary, you can see right here on Sportsnet. That's next Friday at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern. Then the regular season begins. And that is on Wednesday, October the 11th at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern, as the Canucks host the Edmonton Oilers. Canucks came into this one on the Truth and Reconciliation weekend. Nice ceremony before the game and a nice comeback for the home team, who came in as one of only two teams without a preseason win. But they score five unanswered, beat the Oilers 5-2. Stay tuned. Martin Faisel, Sportsnet Central, starts now.